President of the Senate, Ahmad Lawan, has felicitated with Muslim faithful on the commemoration of this year's Eid-el-Maulud. In his goodwill message, he urged Muslims and Nigerians in general to imbibe the virtues of peace, tolerance, justice and love for one another as exemplified by Prophet Muhammad. He said the birthday of the Holy Prophet should be an occasion for renewal of commitment to ideals that will enhance peace and prosperity in Nigeria. He charged Muslims in particular to always emulate the virtues of Prophet Muhammad, which include honesty, love for others and peaceful coexistence. Joining us in the studio is a Muslim cleric, Fatai Olajobi. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
What is the relevance of this celebration? Why is it so important?
Okay, so it's important for us to reflect on the teachings of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to bring back religion into our lives as a people, particularly because of the way the world is presently and Nigeria as a country. The holiday is was given by the government, but for us as Muslims and for those that are non-Muslims, it's for us to reflect on the teachings of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which is quite diverse. And some of the lessons will be to reflect on how trustworthy he was when he lived his life, and how a great neighbor he was to his neighbors, peaceful neighborliness. He was so trustworthy to both Christians and Jews that they could entrust him with their things. He was named Al-Amin, the trusted one. That was the prophet.
Okay, yeah, the president in this message talks about people that are coercing young people, forcing young girls into marriage, and he described it as un-Islamic. What is your take on that?
Okay, so it's actually un-Islamic because there was a time during the time of the Prophet that parents forced their girls to marry people they wanted to marry them to. So he said that you need a consent of the girl child. Of the girl before you can give her out in marriage. She must feel, okay, I want to marry this man before you can give her out in marriage. So it is un-Islamic to force any girl into marriage.
Okay, what practices do you hope that Muslims will carry away from this celebration for the rest of the year and the coming year?
Okay, so I think I would want Muslims to learn the peaceful way the Prophet settled scores with people around him, the way he lived with people that were not of the same religion, and even people that were of the same religion. Because even within the religion, we have people that have issues with themselves. The main thing is to remember the way the Prophet taught us that when you remember death up to about 13 times in a day, you're guaranteed God's favor. But when you remember you'll die one day, you take life, lightly. You don't fight people unnecessarily. You don't. The Prophet taught us to overlook people's mistakes. Even when the Prophet had to go into battles with people, it was during extreme need that he had to do that. We are taught to forgive, like the Prophet forgave his enemies, even when they trampled on his rights, he forgave them. Until when it became unforgivable, his life was at stake. His life and the life of the people around him were in danger before he could, fight. It's not encouraged for any Muslim to start by fighting. You dialogue, find ways of sorting things out. Because really, God has created us from Adam and Eve, whether we like it or not. And that's what I want people to take from this holiday.
Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us and the news.
You're welcome.
Pleasure to have you.
Thank you for having me.